Hi guys, welcome to lecture number 21. In the previous lecture, that is the lecture number 20, we have discussed all the previous year GATE problem from 1991 to 2017 based on three phase rectifier. Okay, and we have completed all the rectifier module, that is a single phase rectifier and three phase rectifier. Then we have seen about the effect of source inductance in all kind of rectifier, that is the single pulse converter, two pulse converter and three pulse converter. Okay, now in this lecture we will start introduction to chopper. Okay, that is the DC to DC converter. So before proceeding further, I would like to say you that in the previous lecture, that is the lecture number 19, I derived the effect of source inductance for two pulse converter like this, and we found that the average value of voltage decreases. So I derived something like this V naught nu, that is equal to 1 upon pi integration of alpha plus mu to pi plus alpha Vm sin omega t d omega t, and I noted down in lecture 19 like this. So this is, please edit this, this is wrong. In place of this, when you will integrate this equation, then you will get that is equal to Vm upon pi integration of sin omega t will give me minus cos omega t, so it will be minus cos pi plus alpha plus cos alpha plus mu. Okay, and we know that cos pi plus alpha is nothing but minus cos alpha, so it will be plus cos alpha. So overall V naught nu I will get Vm upon pi into cos alpha plus mu. This is the correct, I derived there wrongly, so please edit this in your notes. Okay, so what will be the del V naught? Del V naught will be V naught old minus V naught nu. So V naught old I was getting 2 Vm upon pi into cos alpha minus V naught nu will be like this. So it will be, it is again wrong, it will be Vm upon pi into cos alpha minus cos alpha plus mu. This is the correct. So please edit these two points in the previous note, that is the lecture number 19. In order to verify this V naught nu is correct or not, put mu is equal to 0. So if you put mu is equal to 0 in this equation, then you will get V naught nu is equal to V naught old, means we are neglecting source inductance. Okay, so what was the modification there you have to do? You have to note down this V naught nu is equal to this much and del V naught is equal to this much. Okay, and you have to also edit in your notes like I naught is I have calculated, that is correct, but V naught nu is not like this. V naught nu will be Vm upon pi into cos alpha plus mu. Okay, and del V naught I will not get like this, this is wrong. Del V naught I will get something like this, that is equal to Vm upon pi into cos alpha minus cos alpha plus mu. Okay, so this will be del V naught, that is equal to 2 omega ls I naught upon pi that we have derived in the previous lecture, that is the lecture number 19, and that is equal to 4 f ls I naught. So please edit these two points, point number second and point number third, I have calculated in lecture number 19 wrongly. So please edit this in your notes. Now let us move to the lecture number 21, that is introduction to chopper. So chopper is nothing but DC to DC converter. So before starting DC to DC converter, I would like to say you that why DC to DC converter, why we are studying DC to DC converter. Suppose I am giving you supply voltage that is equal to 100 volt and this is my load, and I want that at the load I need 50 volt only, and you have 100 volt DC supply that is fixed. We cannot change this 100 volt DC supply. So what are the steps to be taken such that the voltage drop across load I can get that is equal to 50 volt. So one way of doing is this, is to connect the variable resistor in series with load. Let us say this is R external, such that the 50 volt will drop across this R external resistor. Then you can apply KVL, so you will get 50 volt plus 50 volt that is equal to 100 volts. In this way we can get 50 volt across the output. Now what are the demerit of inserting external resistance? The demerit of inserting external resistance that is equal to P loss, losses will be more. See here, P loss, the losses across this R external will be V square upon R, and the voltage drop across this R external will be 50 square upon R, that will be 2500 upon R. So the losses across R external will be more. It's very high because on a state voltage drop across this R external is very high, that is equal to 50 volt. So this is not worth to do. As a power electronics engineer, you must neglect external resistance, or you can say that you can avoid inserting any resistance into the circuit. Then only your circuit will work at a higher efficiency. So this method is not desirable. Is it fine? So in place of R external, there is another method to do that we have discussed in lecture number 1. That is, we must attach one switch. Let us say this is switch. Okay. In place of R external, we will attach one switch and we will decide the turn on and turn off time of this switch. Let us say I am turning on this switch for T on period. Let us say this is T on period. Okay. This is T on period. Then what will be the output voltage? When the switch will be on, then output voltage is equal to supply voltage. So I can make like this: output voltage is equal to supply voltage, that is equal to 100 volt when switch will be turned on. Now when switch will be turned off, then what will happen? Output voltage I will get, that is equal to 0. So during turn off, this is the turn off time. During turn off, the output voltage I will get, that is equal to 0, like this. Okay. Again, when I will switch on this switch, then it will be, output voltage will be equal to 100 volt, and when the switch will be closed, then output voltage will be 0. So in this way I can vary this output voltage. This is my output voltage V0. So if I'll have to find the average output voltage, then what will be the average output voltage? Average output voltage I will get, that is equal to, let us say this is supply voltage. 100 volt is nothing but supply voltage. Okay. And for how much time it is on? It is on for T on time. And what is the total time period? That is equal to T. Or in other way, you can find the average output voltage by finding the area. Okay. So if you'll find this area, then it will be Vs multiplied by T on upon total time period, that is the average voltage. And we can represent this T on upon T, that is nothing but D, where D is equal to duty cycle. Okay. So if I will make D is equal to 0.5, then what will be the output voltage? See, Vs is equal to 100 volt. So 0.5 into 100, that is equal to 50 volt. So by varying the duty cycle, we can vary the output voltage according to our required value. Got it? Now here, what I am getting? I am getting D is equal to T on upon T. I can write T on is equal to DT. Okay. And where T is the total time period, that can also be written T on plus T off. Is it fine? So T off will come out to be T minus T on, that is equal to, put T on is equal to DT, you will get 1 minus D into T. This you have to keep in mind. Now V naught I got, that is equal to D times of Vs, or I can write like this: T on upon T into Vs. Okay. And by varying the duty cycle, I can get the desired output voltage. So we can get the variable output voltage from fixed input supply. Now see, we are getting output voltage that has some ripple, and ripple, change in voltage, is nothing but supply voltage. See how much ripple is here. Ripple means change in voltage. So change in voltage is nothing but supply voltage here in this case. So we are getting more ripple in the output voltage, means at the DC side we are getting more harmonics, that we have seen in lecture number 1, what is harmonics. So because of this harmonics, we cannot attach a load directly to this circuit. Suppose I want to run one DC motor, so load will be my DC motor. Let us say this is DC motor. Okay. Now if I will attach DC motor to run this motor by using this circuit, then what will happen? Because of this harmonics, I will get both AC component as well as DC component at the output side. So AC component of current will be undesirable for DC motor, right? So it is not desirable to insert DC motor into this circuit. Why? Because of this harmonics, there is more ripple in output voltage. So in order to reduce this ripple, what I will do? We place one capacitor in parallel with load, just like this. This is my capacitor. Because of this capacitor, the ripple voltage, ripple in output voltage will be minimum, and we can make this DC output voltage, variable DC output voltage, into smooth by using this capacitor. If capacitor, the value of capacitor will be more, then this ripple will be less. Now one more thing will change, that is the current. Output current will also change. See here, when switch will be on, then output current you will get, and when switch will be off, then output current will be zero. So in order to reduce the current harmonics, what we have to do, we have to insert one inductor in series with load. So what I will do, I will insert one inductor here like this in series with load, so that it can reduce the current ripple, and this capacitor will reduce the voltage ripple. So by using this proper value of L and C, we can make voltage and current ripple free. Then only we can insert a load like DC motor, or you can say that then only I can use this circuit in practical application. But still this circuit we cannot use for practical purposes. Like, see here what is happening. When switch will gets on, then this inductor will charge, means it will store some amount of energy. And when this switch will be off, then inductor, this inductor will not get any path to discharge. You can see that during off condition, the charge inductor have some energy, so it will not get any path to discharge. Also, we know that from network point of view, this inductor, the charge inductor, cannot be left open. Okay, so there must be path by which the current produced by this inductor can flow. So for that, what we need, we need one diode like this, such that the during off condition, when switch will be off, then this charge inductor will freewheels, the current flowing by this charge inductor will freewheels by this path. Otherwise what will happen, when you will switch off this switch, then what will happen, this charge inductor have some energy, so there will be some spark produced across the switch. This has been asked in IEES interview. So you must know that when inductor is charged, then it cannot be left open, otherwise the spark produces across the switch. So in order to protect the switch, we must have some circulating path for inductor to discharge. That circulating path can be given by this diode. Now this whole combination can be used for practical purpose, and this is nothing but, this is known as DC to DC converter, also known as a step down converter, that is the buck converter. Okay, so what is the difference between chopper and converter, buck converter, boost converter, or buck boost converter? We make chopper by inserting proper value of L, C and diode, so that it can be used for practical application. Chopper is something like this, having supply voltage, one switch and load. This is chopper. Okay, and it cannot be used for practical purpose because of voltage and current harmonics at the output side. So in order to make voltage and current ripple free, we use proper value of L and C, and to circulate the current during off condition, we use this diode as a switching element. Then the circuit form known as DC to DC converter, or you can say that buck converter or boost converter or buck boost converter. So this is the difference between chopper and DC to DC converter. Now we will study in this course, in GATE syllabus, there are three types of converter. First one is the buck converter, second is boost converter, and third one is the buck boost converter. We will see one by one. This is the circuit diagram of buck converter, boost converter and buck boost converter. You can see here that these three are known as switches. These three are known as switches, that is the canonical switch. It is also known as canonical switch. Why it is known as canonical switch? See here, by changing the orientation of canonical switch, we can make buck converter, boost converter and buck boost converter. You can see that if I will interchange these two, means if I will change inductor and diode like this, means diode will be in place of inductor and inductor will be in place of diode, then this will become buck boost converter. You can see that this is buck boost converter. Diode is inserted here and inductor is inserted here. Now for making boost converter, what you have to do? You have to rotate this canonical switch anti-clockwise. If you rotate this canonical switch anti-clockwise, then the circuit you will get, switch will be here, this switch will be here, this diode will be here, and this inductor will be here. Okay, now reverse the polarity of diode, this diode will be somehow like this. Is it fine? So by proper orientation of this canonical switch, we can make buck converter, boost converter, and buck boost converter. Okay, so we will see one by one in detail, but before that I would like to give one some important information, that is the volt second balance, what is volt second balance and what is ampere second balance. So the volt second balance can be written like this: the voltage across inductor during on state multiplied by T on, means for time the switch is on. So VL on into T on plus voltage across this inductor during off state into T off is always be zero. In other words, we can say that the average voltage across inductor is always zero. This is the volt second balance. VL on into T on plus VL off into T off is equal to zero. What are its physical significance? See, it can also be said like that: the inductor during on state the inductor is charging, and during off state the inductor is discharging, means the energy stored by inductor during turn on must be equal to the energy released during turn off, then only it will be a stable circuit. Let us suppose during T on inductor gets charged up to 80 joule, and during turn off inductor get discharged up to 40 joule, then inductor will have some energy, means 80 minus 40 means 40 joule will have some energy. Again, when you close the switch, then inductor will charge up to 80 joule, means total energy present across the inductor will become 80 plus 40, that is equal to 120 joule. Now again inductor discharge to minus 40 joule, so it will have 80 joule. Now again during turn off it will charge to 80 joule, so 80 plus 80, it will be 160 joule. So if charging energy is not equal to discharging energy, then you can see that during each cycle the voltage or energy present across the inductor is increasing like this, which makes the circuit unstable. That's why for a stable circuit we make switching frequency such that whatever the energy inductor are getting during turn on time, it must get discharge during turn off time, then only the circuit will be stable. So in a nutshell, we can say that the VL on into T on plus VL off into TF must be equal to zero, then only the circuit will be stable. This is known as volt second balance, or in other word you can say that the average voltage across inductor must be equal to zero. Okay, now see the ampere second balance. What is ampere second balance? Same concept can be applied for capacitor also. We know that the capacitor, the average current across capacitor is always zero. IC average is equal to zero. So here you can see that IC during on state into T on plus capacitor current during off state into T off must be equal to zero. Concept will remain same. Here during turn on, whatever the capacitor is getting energy must get discharged during turn off state, otherwise you will see that the during each cycle the energy present across capacitor is increasing, which is the sign of unstable system. There may be the time came at which the energy present in the capacitor will be greater than its maximum energy stored, so it will be the unstable state. That's why IC on into T on plus IC off into T off must be equal to zero. So these two points you should know: the volt second, what is volt second balance, and what is ampere second balance. This will help you in deriving some of the important formula in the next lecture. So you have to keep in mind these: what is volt second balance and what is ampere second balance. Now in all this converter, this is buck converter, boost converter, and buck boost converter, I will assume that the load current is constant. First assumption is load current I naught is constant. Okay, means we will talk about continuous conduction mode only. We will not go into the discontinuous conduction mode, because in gate exam none of the question is asked for discontinuous conduction mode, only continuous conduction mode is asked. That's why first I will teach you the continuous conduction mode, and I will take one or two problem for discontinuous conduction mode, and I will solve that problem so that you can understand if discontinuous conduction mode is asked, then how to approach for that kind of problem. Okay, so in all these buck converter, boost converter, and buck boost converter, following parameter we will derive. Okay, first is when switch is on, then what is the value of voltage across inductor and capacitor current? Okay, when switch will be off, then what is the voltage across inductor and what is the current across capacitor? We will find these things. Third point is volt second balance. Fourth point is ampere second balance. We will use these two balance to find average output voltage and average output current. We will find these things. Now the fifth point is ripple in inductor current, that is del IL, we will find. Then IL max I will find, IL minimum I will find. Then eighth point is source current, average source current and RMS source current we will find. Diode current, that is average diode current and RMS diode current we will find. Tenth point is ripple in capacitor voltage or ripple in output voltage, both are same. So we will find ripple in output voltage, that is del V naught, that is equal to del VC. So we will find one by one these all formula in all the converter. 11 point at what D ripple is maximum we will find. Critical value of inductance as well as critical value of capacitance. So these 13 point we will find in all the convert. Okay, and the sequence of finding is like this, from 1 to 13. And at the end you will came to know that the finding of each and every formula in all the converter is same. So no need to by heart all the formula, only I will give you the steps of finding. And you will came to know that by using that step, you can easily solve any kind of problem in buck converter, boost converter and buck boost converter. So in the next lecture, we will start buck converter and we will find these all parameters, these all formula. So that's all about this lecture. If you guys understood the concept, then please like this video and subscribe to this channel. For doubt solving, you can join our Facebook group. Thanks for watching this video.